FIDR works, FIDR is this organization I represent. FIDR works in the public policy space and specifically in ITC and information technology and communication technology, and it also works in tech for good, which means that I should be spending about half a minute more on telling you or urging you why you should look at Odisha differently. Now first, it will not be an exaggeration to say that in our blueprint, in our vision, we see that in the next 5 to 7 years, Odisha should be contributing to about 6% national GDP, which means that Odisha would not only be bracketed as a minerals state, it's not the metal industry that will be driving Odisha's economy, but it will also be the knowledge base, which again means that you have already heard the government's role in providing the ecosystem. And besides the ecosystem, it is also the kind of policy changes or the kind of policy environment that enables this to happen. So there are a couple of points. Due to paucity of time, I'll just touch upon a couple of things that I suggest would also help, because these are the strengths that we have. It will also help aggregate the available resources, the available investments in startup concerns. When I was talking to Prashant just before this session, I was amazed at the scale. He said in the last 30 months, 558 startups have already been registered, and they're full-fledged startups, which means it's no more a startup for Odisha, it's a scale-up for Odisha. It has already started, it's scaling up. First point is, now CSR funds in Odisha, We have done a survey. It says that in the last about 4 or 5 years, we have about 1700 crores from CSR funds. But for startup, there is a provision where CSR from PSUs can only provide the seed money or the investment that's required under CSR. That would mean that the civil society has this responsibility of having that kitty to be spread across different districts, not only from the PSUs, but also to stretch that to cover the private sector. Second point, strengths of Odisha. Odisha has been thinking of pioneering the alumni movement in no school, no college, even in smart city, even in skill development profession, which means that if you are looking for diaspora, if you are looking for people to provide you the network for startup, provide you the network for not only technology, for the processes, and also for the post-process, post-output marketing and sales, then this is the best time for Odisha, because we have a strong, more school and more college and other alumni networks. The third point that I want to quickly make is that every district should have already has a startup cell, which means that a district or a below district level college should have a startup cell. Now, if we catch them young and if we instill this right from the school and college, then we have a long future for startup, which is already have had flying colors so far. And another point, important point, is that I would urge the OIEPO to take advantage of the Odia diaspora, not only in India but also outside India. So they already have NRSL, and if we could have a business slash corporate kind of a group, it could be online, offline, and that would provide immense support to the startup ecosystem of the state. Now, hailing from the state, that's why I'm taking all these strengths of our state and providing this blueprint and a few suggestions. And some of the focus sectors for startups should be, of course, minerals, metals, because we should let go the advantage we already have, and agriculture, and tourism. So if we have, say for example, a startup hub in Konar, a startup hub in Raigada, a startup hub in Aska, so if you spread out these startup hubs, that they themselves will aggregate and make a state-specific startup focus. Thank you.